Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on example problem on a priori algorithm in data warehousing and data mining. It is one of the most important concept in data warehousing and data mining concept. First of all, what is the main objective of a priori algorithm? A priori algorithm is used for finding frequent item sets in the given transaction database. Okay, next one. What is frequent item set? So the items that are appeared in the transactional database frequently. So that items are called as frequent item set. Next one. What is item set? Item set is nothing but set of items that are put in a transaction is called as item set. Okay, now we go for example problem. Okay, so this is the transactional database. In that transactional database, there are two columns are there. The first column represents the transaction IDs that are T1 to T9 are there. Second column represents list of item IDs. There are 5 items are there. So I1, I2, I3, I4 and I5. These are the item IDs. Next, these are the 9 transactions. Each and every transaction can be done by one particular customer. In that transaction, these are the items that are purchased by the customer. Okay. Now, in that transactional database, capital D, so what are the frequent item sets that are purchased by the customer? That we have to find out by using a priori algorithm. Mainly, a priori algorithm is used for finding frequent item sets in the transactional database. The items that are purchased frequently by the customer in a particular transaction, that is called as a frequent item sets. Okay, next. So this is initially we are taking as input to the algorithm. Okay, first step, scan D for count of each candidate. So that means scanning the database D for count of each candidate. So here the candidates are the item IDs. Here I1, I2, I3, I4 and I5 are there. So this is the candidate item set 1. In that candidate item set 1 is represented by C1. It consists of what are the item IDs are there. Here there are 5 item IDs are there. That is I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. Okay. So, how many times I1 is there in 9 transaction? So, that is represented by the support count. Support count means how many number of times that item is purchased in 9 transactions. So, that is called as support count. Okay. So, first, I1. I1, how many times is there in the transaction database? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I1 is occurred 6 times. Next one, I2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I2 is purchased 7 times. Next, I3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I3 is 6 times purchased. Next, I4. 1, 2, yes, 2 times is I4 is purchased. Next, I5. 1 and 2. 2 times it is purchased. Okay. Next, after calculating the support count of each and every item in the transaction database, then we are getting C1. Now, compare candidate support count with the minimum support count. So, this is the candidate support count of I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. This candidate support count is compared with minimum support count. Here minimum support count is equal to 2. So now compare the candidate support count is with the minimum support count. If it is less than 2, then it can be pruning from the database. If it is greater than 2, greater than or equal to 2, it can be exist in that candidate item set. Okay, now here 6. 6 is compared with 2. It is greater than 2. Now it is exist. Next, 7 is compared with 2. It is greater than or equal to 2. So I2 is exist. Next, I3 support count is 6. 6 is greater than or equal to 2. Yes, it is exist. Next, I4 support count is greater than or equal to 2. Yes, it is exist. Next, I5 support count is greater than or equal to 2. Yes, it is exist. All the candidates have the support count greater than or equal to the minimum support count, that is 2, so that all the candidate items are exist. Now it becomes the L1. Okay, each candidate item support count is there in C1. Next, each candidate support count is compared with the minimum support count. If it is less than 2, then it can be pruned from that candidate item set. Otherwise, it can be exist in that one. Now, whatever the result we are getting, that is called as L1. Okay, next one. Generate candidate item set 2 from L1. This is L1. From this L1, we are generating the candidate item set 2. That means the C2 contains two candidate item sets. Okay, so here first candidate item set I1 is combined with the remaining candidate item sets. So I1 is combined with I2, we are getting I1, I2. I1 is combined with I3, we are getting I1, I3. I1 is combined with I4, we are getting I1, I4. I1 is combined with I5, we are getting I1, I5. Next, I2 can be combined with greater than that index. So that means I2 is combined with only I3. I2 is combined with only I4. I2 is combined with I5. Okay. So I2, I3, I2, I4, I2, I5. Next, go for I3. I3 is combined with greater than that. So I3 is combined with I4. I3 is combined with I5. Next one. I4 is combined with I5. So these are the candidate item set. It contains two candidates. Okay. So the first one is I1, I2. I1, I2 support count. So I1, I2 one time. I1, I2 two time. I1, I2 three times. I1, I2 four times. Okay. So four times I1 and I2 are bought together in the transaction database. So this is 4. Okay. So next one is I1, I3. I1, I3, how many times they are bought together? So I1, I3. So first one, second one, I1, I3. Third one, I1, I3. Fourth one. So four times it is purchased, bought together. Okay. Next one, I1, I4. So I1, I4. Okay, intermediate. Many item IDs are also available. I1, I4. One time. Only one time. So I1 and I4 items are purchased together only one time. Next one, I1, I5. I1, I5. One time. I1, I5. Two times. I1, I5. Two times. Next one, I2, I3. I2, I3. First time. Second time, third time, fourth time, only four times. So I1 and I3 items are purchased together 4 times in the transaction database. Next one, I2, I4. I2, I5 1 time, 2 time, only 2 times. I2 and I4 items are purchased together 2 times in the transaction database. Next one, I2, I5. I2, I5 1st time, 2nd time. Only 2 times I2 and I5 are purchased together. Next one, I3, I4. I3, I4. I3, I4. So, no. I3 and I4 are not purchased together in the transaction database. So, its support count is 0. Okay. Next one, I3, I5. I3, I5 1 time. Only 1 time. I3 and I5 are purchased together only 1 time in the transaction database. I4, I5. I4, I5. 0. 0 time. I4 and I5 are not purchased together in the transaction database. Once we are getting the candidate item set C2 corresponding its support count in the transaction database, that support count is compared with the minimum support count. If it is greater than or equal to its minimum support count, it is exist in L2. Otherwise, it can be proved from L2. Okay. First one here, 4. 4 is compared with 2. So, it is greater than or equal to 2. So, it is exist. Next one, I1, I3. Its support count is 4. 4 is greater than or equal to 2. It can be exist. Next one, I1, I4. Its support count is 1. So, 1 is greater than or equal to 2. That is false. So, that this can be discarded. Okay. So, it can be discarded. Next one, I1, I5. Its support count is 2. 2 greater than or equal to 2. So, true, it can be exist in the database. Next one, I2, I3. Its support count is 4. 4 is greater than or equal to 2. It can be exist in the database. Next one, I2, I4. Its support count is 2. 2 greater than or equal to 2. So, it can be exist in the database. Next, I2, I5. Its support count is greater than or equal to 2. So that it can be exist in the database. Next, I3, I4, its support count is 0. 0 greater than or equal to 2. So it cannot be exist in L2. Next, I3, I5, its support count is 1. 1 greater than or equal to 2. That is false. It cannot be exist in L2. Next, I4, I5, its support count is 0. 0 greater than or equal to 2. That is false. It cannot be exist in L2. Okay. So, in L2, what are the candidate item set C2 contains its support count greater than or equal to 2 that can be exist in L2 only. The remaining item sets that can be discarded. Okay. Because its support count is less than 2. Minimum support count, that is 2. So, they can be pruned from the candidate item set C2. Okay. Candidate item set C2. The remaining are there in L2. Next, generate candidate item set C3 from L2. Okay. So, now, how we are getting candidate item set C3? C3 contains only 3 candidate item sets. Now, observe. Here I1, I2 is there. Here I1, I3 is there. Okay. So, by combining this one, we are getting I1, I2, I3. By combining these two, we are getting. So, when we are combining, at least one item ID is common. So, here I1, I2, I1, I3. Which one is common? I1 is common. So, that we are getting I1, I2, I3. Next one is I1, I2, I1, I5. In that one, I1 is common. Then we are getting I1, I2, I5. Okay. Next one is I1, I2, I2, I3. From these two, we are getting I1, I2, I3. Next one, I1, I2, I2, I4. From these two, I2 is common. Then we are getting I1, I2, I4. Next one, I1, I2, I2, I5. From these two, we are getting I2 is common. Then we are getting I1, I2, I5. Next one, from these two, we are getting I1, I3. Here, I2, I3. So, from these two, I3 is common. Then we are getting I1, I2, I3. Next one, okay. Next one, I1, I5. Here, I2, I5. From these two, we are getting I1, I2, I5. I1, I2, I4. Here, I2, I5. From these two, we are getting I2, I4, I5. Okay. So, these are the candidate item sets we are getting from this L2. Any two candidate item sets are combined, then one item set is common in between them, then we have to combine them. Then we are getting, these are the seven candidate item sets C3. Now, calculate its support count. I1, I2, I3. How many times it is occurred? So, first time, second time, only two times. So, I1, I2, I3. These three items are bought together in the transaction database two times. Next, I1, I2, I5. I1, I2, I5. One time. I1, I2, I5. Two times. So, these three items are purchased together two times in the transaction database. Next one, I1, I2, I4. So, I1, I2, I4. First time. Only one time. So, these three items are purchased together only one time. Next one, I1, I3, I5. I1, I3, I5. Only one time. So, these three items are purchased together only one time. Okay. Next one, I2, I3, I4. I2, I3, I4. I2, I3, I4. They are not there. So, I2, I3, I4 are not purchased together. Next one, I2, I3, I5. One time, only one time, I2, I3, I5 are purchased together. Next, I2, I4, I5. I2, I4, I5. No, I2, I4, I5 are not purchased together. Okay, now, these candidate item sets C3 support count is compared with the minimum support count. If it is greater than or equal to 2, that can be exist. If it is less than 2, that can be pruned from the C3. Okay. So, here I1, I2, I3, its support count is 2. 2 greater than or equal to minimum support count 2. So, it can be exist. Okay. Next, I1, I2, I5. Its support count is 2. 2 is compared with the minimum support count. It is greater than or equal to 2 so that it can be exist. The remaining all are the support counts of these candidate item set C3 are less than the minimum support count so that these 4 are discarded. These 5 are discarded from L3. Okay, so then we are getting L3 contains only two candidate item sets. So that is set of I1, I2, I3. Its support count is 2. I1, I2, I5. Its support count is 2. Okay, now this is L3. Okay, L3 is getting from C3. So C3 is getting from L2. L2 is getting from C2. C2 is getting from L1. L1 is getting from C1. Now, calculate C4 from L3. Okay. So, C4 means the candidate item sets contains 4 item IDs. Okay. By only there are 2 item sets are there. By clubbing these 2 item sets, here I1 and I2 are common. Okay. Then, after combining them, we are getting I1, I2, I3, I5. I1, I2, I3, I5. So, its support count is only I1, I2, I3, I5. I1, I2, I3, I5. Its support count is 1. Okay. Now, this can be compared with the minimum support count. It is less than 2. So then it can be discarded. Now L4 does not contain any item sets. Okay. Whenever L4 does not contain any item sets, then the a priori algorithm can be terminated. Okay. Now, what are the frequent item sets? So this is LK. Suppose L suffix K is equal to pi. L suffix K is equal to pi. That is L4 is equal to pi. That means L4 does not contain any candidate item sets. Now, so L suffix K minus 1, that is equal to L suffix 4 minus 1, that is equal to L3. So L3 contains the frequent item sets. L3 contains what are the frequent item sets? That is set of I1, I2, I3 and set of I1, I2, I5. So whatever I am telling, this can be right. Whenever L suffix 4 is equal to pi, the algorithm terminated. The item sets in L suffix 4 minus 1, that is L suffix 3, are frequent. So in the L suffix 3, what are the item sets are there? I1, I2, I3, I1, I2, I3, I1, I2, I5, I1, I2, I5. So these are the frequent item sets from this transaction database. Okay. So this algorithm is terminated whenever L suffix K is equal to pi. Okay. Whenever L suffix K is equal to pi, so frequent item sets are there in L suffix K minus 1. Here L suffix 4 is equal to pi. The frequent item sets are there in L suffix K minus 1. That is L suffix 4 minus 1. That is it. L suffix 3. In the L suffix 3, these are the two item sets are there. These are the frequent item sets. So this is the description about the example problem on a priori algorithm. In this way, we have to find out the frequent item sets from the given transaction database by using a priori algorithm. So thank you. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and classmates. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name. So Divvela Srinivasa Rao.